functioning and good. So growing up, I see things going on in this country, lots of racism, underachievers, but then I decided that I would volunteer in a Saturn school when I was like 21, 22. I saw a boy, 5 years old, who had been excluded from 7 nurseries.
Wow.
5 years old. The teacher at the nursery said the boy was unteachable. But we taught that boy how to write his name in hieroglyphics in 2 hours. We taught that boy algebra, a 5-year-old boy, algebra. So how the hell is that boy unteachable? So I'm seeing this, and this is the time where all the press is going on saying, but that children are underachieving. And this Saturday school, of 30 children, we're teaching 5 or 6 year olds algebra, hieroglyphics. We teach them about things they don't never learn in school until year 7 and 8, until secondary school. My daughter came into school. So I said to myself, my children are going to go to Saturday school, they'll be compulsory, my choice. 10 years later, I had my children. My daughter came to that same school. She learned about Mary Seacole. Before, it was a big hoo-ha guy. She learned about it. And they went to school, and they started talking about Florence Nightingale in the class. She got talented. She goes, miss, it wasn't Florence Nightingale doing the work, it was Mary Seacole. Teacher's like, who's Mary Seacole? Come up here and tell us about Mary Seacole. She talked the whole class about Mary Seacole. They went to the British Museum, and they saw the hieroglyphics written on the walls. And the teacher's like, oh, this is some nice writing from ancient Egypt. It's very nice. She goes, miss, I don't know what it means. She goes, of course you do, dear. Of course you do. Yes, dear. She turned her back on it. She goes, but miss, I don't know what it means. She goes, okay, young lady. If you think you're smart, come and teach the class. And she did. She went through the pronunciation. She went to explain what they meant. But she learned this in our schools from our own education system. So, we must stop relying on their chase of students to contend with their lives. And the children that are coming through the Saturday school system are doing absolutely fantastic. The amount of them that are going through university is unspoken. The amount of them that are on campus is unspoken, which is why I run the National Association of Black Suburban Schools, is to tell these stories. So I have a YouTube channel called NABSS 2007, where I interview the parents and the teachers in these schools. And I actually taught in the schools to help out. And the things that we've taught, and a lot of the teachers in the schools are unqualified teachers. These are parents who have been through the system and understand how to teach simple things in a simple way. I severely underachieved in maths. I didn't know a clue about fractions. But this parent taught me how to do fractions so simply. I'm like, wow, that is so simple. How come I wasn't taught that in school? Now, other parents don't play in my children's school. And this thing about relationships, sex education came up. They renamed it as relationships. A lot of parents about France said, no, I don't want children learning sex education, I don't want children doing it. I said, look, listen, to squash all these fears, let's get the teacher that teaches relationships to come into the parents' group and teach us about it. She came in and she said, listen, it's not about sex, it's about body image, it's about media, social media, and how you see yourself. It's not all about sex. That's great. So we actually understand what it is. So I thought to myself, okay. So if this teacher can come in and explain what that lesson's about, let's have a teacher from every lesson come to the parents and explain what goes on in the school. The maths teacher came in. She said, I said to her, look, give us a maths lesson that you give to the children. She's like, I was so bored, I felt like throwing paper at myself. So basically, I said to my daughter, this is a teacher, does she actually teach you maths? She said she's bored as hell. She is bored. But when she came to the science school, we had a parent teaching maths, get them out of their seats, throw in a ball, give us the equation, give us the ball back, say your name, feel interactive. Our children are bored stiff with Victorian teaching methods. Bored stiff, which is why we need to fund our own school.
Really, Naya. We don't need to.
In our own time, we need to our own school. I've been part of the free school initiative. Before the free school scam came out, I've been trying to set my own full-time black school since 2005. And this free school thing is an absolute dirty, stinking scam. It's undercover privatization of the schooling system. The government has no money whatsoever to do with new schools. It's all private money. So we need our own finances. Forget the government, our own finances to build and fund our own schools. Unless we do that, we are failing our children. Thank you very much.